What's up, everybody? Welcome to the Kings of War Vanguard Battle Reports. We're on a game two of the Ice and Iron missions. This is going to be Snowblind. So we're wandering around. We've heard that there's a tablet of arcane power. You're trying to stop the Undead from getting it to unleash all kinds of terribleness.
We're going to unleash all the Undead. terrible.
There's some Klaatu, Verata, Nyctu stuff. We're just going to make sure that it doesn't involve the appropriate level of Klaatu or Verata or Nyctu. We've got 175 points to play with now out of our warbands. But we still got to feed everybody, so I got to make sure everybody's wearing pants and got spears and stuff. So we'll deploy and muster our warbands and get this underway.
So here's my undead, led by Rashraz the Tall, my necromancer. He's a lizardy necromancer. And he's added another command model. We got Gunter, the Crypt Gouger. He's there to go and dig up some bodies and leave grave marks and stuff. And then we have the Urk and Gurk, the two zombie orcs. We have the Huddle, which is the name of my gore blight rather. And then we've got some of the boys here. These guys don't get names, they're skeletons, they get replaced when they die. So we got skeleton archer, two regular skeletons, a skeleton with a spear, and some bats. And here's Owen's 175 points of the Brotherhood. What do we got?
So in the front we have our exemplar Rudolph, and then beside him we have our devoted Margaret. We have our 5 foot knights, Otto, Francis, Leo, Louis, and Arnulf. And then we have grunts. They're spear boys.
Yeah. They're peasants. They come from no noble family.
Exactly. You don't get a name. you get a number. 1, 2, green.
Here's our mountain table set up for Snowblind. There is a blizzard raging. There are 4 opposite deployment zones. We each get 2 that are opposite each other. So here and here or here and here. They're 8x4, 12 inches on. And we're looking basically just to fight and survive long enough so that at the end of turn 2, the tablet is revealed. And it's revealed through a dice roll. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. It's going to go around. And whoever holds the tablet, you can pick it up as a short action. You become fixed maximum move of 4, and you have to be holding it at the end of the game to win. All right, so rolling off right now. The deployment zones are basically not within 4 of the table edge and behind these dice. So it's like an 8x4 rectangle. And we'll dice off right now to see who is going first. 5, 3, so you get to pick a zone, and the opposite zone. So Owen's picked to go over here and over here. Each zone has to have at least 3 models in it, and I'll deploy after. We're deployed! So across from me, we've got the exemplar in the back with your devoted and your 5 foot knights. You've got the peasants over here with their spears. I'm with my necromancer, 3 skeletons, one of which has a spear, and my my bats over on this side. And on this side, my gore blight, my 2 warriors, orc warrior zombies, my crypt gouger, and my bunch. Going first, you get +1 as he goes first. I got an 8.
I'm probably not gonna beat that.
Nope. So I got my base 3 red, +2 white and 2 red for friends on the table. And I'm gonna get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 total. So 6 power points for me, for you.
I have 6 red and a blue.
Reroll one of those. Sure, yeah, sorry.
I'll reroll one of these guys. Okay.
Okay. 2. My first activation. So what do we want to do? Well, I'm going to make this simple, and we are going to go with the Crypt Gouger, and he is going to dig a grave to place a 25mm grave marker anywhere within 4 inches. I'll place a grave marker right there, and then I am going to spend 2 power points for the Brains ability on him, and a 4, and I'm going to raise a zombie. I can raise that zombie within, I believe, 3. He's gonna count as activated. And then we're just gonna walk with our last one. And Mr. Crypt Gouger is gonna do his speed of 5. He's just gonna walk over here. Over to you.
Well, we're gonna go with that little red fellow over there.
A little peasant.
And now if I'm outside of 4, he won't be able to charge me. And it's a long skill to charge, right?
That's right, he's on line of sight.
So I can't charge you, though I would have been close enough, but he'll just kinda mosey on up and sit outside that 4.
Well, I guess we're gonna go with the Gore Blight. Or am I? Now we'll go with the armored zombie, but I think we're gonna actually use some power points. 2 power through a group defense, and we're gonna use team these orcs. And just gonna dirtle up like so and be bringing it back to you.
All right. Well, go get him, buddy. Back up your friend.
All right, back to me. I think the archer, I just want to dirtle the archer. Now we're gonna go with the Gore Blight. He only walks 3. He's not very fast. So he's just gonna run, and he'll run 6 up to here.
Running 10.
getting ready to trounce you from behind.
Okay, Team Skeleton. I'm just gonna go hide behind here.
He's gonna walk, doing his 5-inch walk along, and then he'll also brace, because they can brace as a short skill.
And then we're gonna go over here and run again. Running around the corner with Team Skeleton.
Walk it up. Right like so, and brace.
Spear in.
Guards.
Oh, it's flap flap. We're gonna fly behind you because we have the fly skill. Hello. Let's decide who we want to fly with. And done. Back to you.
Boss will go. He'll stand a little bit behind.
Get in the midst of it. Yeah. Just use a long skill, and we're going to summon a skeleton.
Devoted's gonna walk up. And just be behind him.
Mist of Faith?
Yeah, the faction-specific spell, Mist of Faith, to make it so that all attacks, melee and range, targeting friendly models within 6 are -1 to hit.
Till the end of the round.
Till the end of the round.
It's got the Crypt Gouger left. Not the Crypt Gouger, sorry. The Skeleton Archer. It's not really worth me doing anything right now. So we're just going to burn our activations. We'll brace, I guess. This is just you.
So we're just going to do some move braces if it's just me now. And these guys are going to kind of
watch the rear. Flank. Yeah. Right, round 2 of potentially 6. So let's see who's... Sorry, actually, you finished activating last, so I'll activate first this round. Roll! I got 1, 2, 3, 6 total. You. Nice.
2, 4, 6, 8, plus 1?
8. I got first. Line is increased to 8. At the end of this round, the tablet is going to appear. So I think we're going to make it an easy one, and we're going to charge with Yon Bat Swarm. Just fall over here. You have to bite some bats. 2d8 plus 1 becomes 3d8 for the bat swarm. They have crushing strength 1 because I'm attacking you at the rear. And I hit on 5s. There's 2. At minus 1.
6 plus. He's dead.
Dead, because he's just a grunt.
Yep.
I'll make consolidate. And I'll head this way so I can't be retaliated against.
All together, boys. We're going to do a group charge for 2.
Okay.
And these 3 guys are going in on that big critter.
Oh, jeez.
We're gonna see if we can just tackle him to death.
Okay.
Yeah. Oh, can't fire there. Little guy there. Little fella like that. And let's see if we can kill him.
That's one dice, because you're...
Fighting you.
Fighting me? So
we'll do the first little guy. He's melee 4 with 3 dice then. So he's gonna get 1 success.
Sweet. Strength of... A crushing?
No.
Okay, so just armor 5 up. Okay.
Yep. The second guy, he gets 1, 2, 3. Just smacking you.
5 up. 1, 1. So I take 2 down to 3 left. No, sorry, 4 left. The boss.
The boss also hitting on 4s. He has 5 dice on the charge. 5. Crushing's 2.
Okay. The boss becomes 6, 7 ups. Dead.
5.
So I automatically have down but not out, because I am within 6 of this guy. Down, I have 5 wounds on me. Troll. Alright, well, I guess the huddle just stands up. Steady, I can't be knocked down. Save against getting knocked down, sorry. And I pass. So I'm taking 5 wounds, and my down but not out becomes just knocked out. I think I'm still fatigued, though. Well, then we're not gonna activate that guy, because I made my steady save, so who do we want to go with? I think we're just gonna go with the zombie, and he's gonna charge this guy. It goes to 2d8 because I charge, hit on a 6. 1. Take the hit.
Armor is 3 plus. He's okay.
They're attacking back, which makes sense, and it's over to you.
Yeah, I think we're going to have our devoted go. And she is going to use her short skill to put the mist back up to give everyone in 6 minus 1 to hit.
Sweet.
For us, I'm safe from these two if I hide behind this rock.
For sure, yeah.
So that's where she's gonna stay, and that's that.
Well, I'm gonna go with the Crypt Gouger. Yes, I'm gonna go with the Crypt Gouger, and he. Don't want to do that now. Nah, I'll charge some guys from the rear, I think. 2 for a group assault. Put down to 4. And have the 2 zombie orcs charge these fools. So he's gonna charge this one in the rear. Blurp. And then his friend's gonna charge the other one. And I guess we fight! So, they are -1 to hit, so hitting on 6s instead of 5s, but they are vicious. And they have 2 attacks, goes to 3 because they charged. So the guy on the left One hit. Crushing one, so it offsets your brace.
4+. Takes a wound.
Takes a wound. Counter attack.
Because I'm going to kill you and then brace.
That makes sense. And then the other one's going to go.
Yep.
And hit not at all, but vicious. Hits once.
Last plus. He's good.
All right, back to you. Everyone's going to go.
And he'll charge this little skelly man.
Not the skelly man.
Uh-huh.
The shank.
Yeah, 2 dice. 3 dice because he charged.
Get thrown for you.
There we are. Hitting on 5s.
One. That is a skelly man, and he is 5 armor. We're good. We're going to go with, I guess, Team Crypt Gudger. And he's going to take a walk. He walks 5, I think. 5, yes. Walk over to here. And then he is going to, I think, raise another zombie. He's going to move again, actually. Do I want to do that? No, I'm good. I don't want to spend the power. What else could I do? I could use the power. I don't want to use the power. No, I'm just going to go over here. Move again. Stand there. Again.
Yeah.
4 dice now because you got a friend.
Yep. 1, 2, 3.
Uh-oh.
4, 5, 6.
Sure.
Take them down, boys.
Well, I rolled an 8. 2 8s, actually. And the third one, 3 8s. Oh, my God. 3 8s. I get to roll 3 more dice. I've succeeded 4 times. 9, 10. I can't believe he's alive. I think we're going with the boss, and he's just going to run. And run 10. 8. And then 2 more. Over to here. Woo! Here he is.
Okay. This guy will go. He's going to fight this fella and just turn on his side. Give you a stab.
Yep.
2 dice, because they are just 2 dice fighters. I do believe. 4 on a 7.
Okay. Orcman is saving on a 5. Good. I'm going to retaliate. DeMarcus is fatigued. Yes. Fight ya. So he's got 2 dice. Hitting on 5s. 6s because you're standing there. Vicious. Take one. Uh-oh. Take one. You're rolling ones. Take one.
Takes a wound.
Good. Is he...
Nope, because he just attacked.
Right. Both wounded. Well, I think the skelly mans are going to go. We're going to leave one there. The other ones, I think, are going to run back. So we're going to come around here. 8. Back to these guys. I'm gonna turn and fight.
Yep. Swing at you. Take 2.
On 4s. Looking for 5s. Nope. Take 2. Automatically down, but not out. So I'm knocked out. You're done. Which means you're gonna get to go first next turn. I guess we go with the archer. He's just gonna brace again. Burn his activation, basically. Mr. Spear's gonna run. Just support his friend. And he's gonna go behind here. And you're first next turn. The Gorblade does get to go. I think I'm just gonna brace. Well, oh, that's right. I'm fatigued. That's right. And we're melee. I can't brace. I'm just going to burn my activation then. So that's ends. Do you want to buy fatigue off anybody?
None of my guys are fatigued.
And nobody fought back? Okay. I'm going to use 4 then to use Tormentor Flails. I use the ability in the end phase. Every enemy model within 3 in line of sight hit with an ND8 melee attack from this model where the amount of power used minimum spent is 1. No retaliations are possible. So I'm going to do a 4d8 attack against everybody. The huddle is leveled up, so he is hitting on a 4, but -1 because you're lady there, so on a 5. And the left. Yeah. Pray the 1.
Yeah. He's okay.
Okay.
It is bash or crushing as well.
Yeah.
I mean, I rolled a 6.
It's crushing too. Stupid. Yeah.
That's perfect then.
Okay.
Need 6s.
Against the other guy on the right. 1. Exploding. 1.
6s. He takes a wound.
Okay. And then against your boss, nothing.
We just totally saved you.
2. You can roll for it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. The tablet appears. There. Just gets replaced with it. Whoop. Roll for you. Nice. 2, 4, 6, 8. 9. And for me, it's 5 and 2. So you got 9. I've got 4. First.
All right. Well, I guess we try and kill this big guy, or we're just going to chain activate, which is probably the way to do this.
Okay. He's going to go?
Yeah. She's going to activate first. She's going to short skill, do the aura again.
Yep.
And then other short skill, she's going to cast heal on this fella.
Did she see him?
It's the front like that, right?
Mm-hmm.
Just this guy. Oh, can I see through your orc?
I don't think so. Because I'm height 2. Are you height 2?
She'll heal that guy.
Okay.
And he at least a success.
Nope.
And a chain activate.
Okay.
So that's her done.
Down to 8 power.
Spend a power. And we'll activate. Oh, let's make it the guy who I tried to heal first.
Okay. Stab my warrior.
He'll take a swing at you, and he'll buy a dice. Going to 7. Looking for 4s. Getting 2.
2. Okay. So I'm armor 5 up. Fail. So I'm minus 1 on my nerve check.
Your guy's
8.
There.
The standing guy. Never mind. Sorry. I'm just knocked down. Make a follow up if you want. Actually, no. Sorry. I think I have to be dead to make a follow up. I think you're still engaged. But you could walk away and I can't attack you.
Reposition.
Do a short action. Yeah.
He's going to walk over to this side.
Cool. Over to me. All right. We're going to do the boss. He's going to walk 5. Over to you. He's going to cast a heal on the huddle. Die. Down to 3. And let's get some successes. 1, 2. So he's going to go to 3 wounds. I think I'm going to chain activate, and I'm just going to stand up this orc, who's tired and stuff. Let's be down to 2. Going to go.
Yeah, we're just going to try and down this big guy again.
Okay.
So he's 4 dice base, 6 dice because he's got 2 friends with him. If I could steal one more dice, and then he's hitting on 4s. Down big guy. Yeah, that's
1, 3. 2, 3.
4, 5.
At five at minus 2. Oops. Saving on 5, 6, 7s. 1, 2, 3. So I take 2 down to 1. I think I'm going to retaliate. I'm fatigued. So I become activated. I retaliate. I'm going to become activated for that.
Mm-hmm.
Whoop. And we're going to hit your boss. 5d8 at minus 1. So I'm hitting on 5 instead of 4 because I'm leveled up. 1.
The best.
Crush rank 2.
Taking a wound.
Wounded guy.
Yep. He's going to try and finish you off, and he'll spend an extra 1 to buy another dice.
Turn to 5 power for that chain.
Ah, 1 hit.
1 hit. Okay. 5 up.
Knocks you down.
Take a wound. So now I become 5
potentially
up. 5 up. Yeah, I'm not knocked down. I am. So I'm KD. Ouch. Me now. Well, oh, you got
move again.
2 activated guys.
He's gonna break.
He could walk away with a short skill. Yeah,
just be there, having done his duty.
I think we are going to do the Crypt Gouger, and he's gonna charge this guy in the rear. Nice start in your rear arc. So in your rear 180.
Oh,
it's where I am.
It's not. There's no sides. It's just front. Back.
No, it's just front back. Yeah.
Oh.
And we've got the heavy blade, so we're gonna be crushing strength 2 for this. Jax, but I'll buy an extra 1 for 4. And try and club ya on keys melee, probably not great. 5 up, 4 up, or 6 up because of your lady. 1.
Parry.
We can still do it.
Reroll the 8.
Okay. Still one. Hits, just 1. Minus 2.
6 plus.
Tally 8.
And then it's over to me.
Yep.
All right, well, that guy is going to go though, and he is going to try and club this giant undead monster.
Okay.
How many dice can I buy? Is it only 1?
Just 1. Yeah, you can do each of the things once.
Then he'll buy a dice.
Okay, get him.
Hitting on 4s, or he gets an extra 1 because you're knocked down, and because his buddy's nearby.
No, you get crushing strength because I'm knocked down.
Then because his buddy's nearby.
Yes.
4s. 1, 2, 3. 3 at crushing 1. It's just against your nerve. Oh, no, you get your armor
still. Take my armor still, yeah. It's how many go through will affect my nerve. Pass. So it's 5 up goes to 6 up. Pass 1. So 2 get through, so I'm minus 2 to my nerve. Sorry, minus 1 to my nerve, because 1 wounds me, 1 goes below my wound value. So 4 becomes 5 up. Spend this to buy an extra die. Gorblade is dead. Well, it's back to me. I'm out of power at this point. I think we go with this fool. And he just stands up.
And that's him.
He's gonna go.
Stab this manster.
Get him.
He'll buy a dice. Getting 4 because his friend's nearby.
Nope.
You tried.
Okay.
Ah, well, chain activate too because I can afford it.
Okay.
So he'll only have 3 dice. Red chip. 2.
Sweet. 5 up. Nope. And he's on my dead. Yeah, he's burnt.
And then he can move. So he's just going to kind of protect his friend's bum from those guys.
Let's charge in. And we go to here. Nice, because I charge and I have a spear friend nearby, hitting on 5s. No. Sixes. My bad. So he's done. Rear.
He's going to just bash this orc. You're already activated, so yep. You can't retaliate, right?
If I'm activated, I can retaliate. I become fatigued.
I see. Yeah, we'll try and knock him down. I'll buy a dice. One.
Okay, five up. Take him down again. Yeah, he was out of wound, which means he goes to downed.
But your friend's nearby.
And fatigued. I'm knocked down, so I'm fatigued as well. I'm going to walk away.
Yep, he'll hang out over here.
Oh, no, he's out of wound. I'm out of fatigue. Okay, then. Well, I guess we go over here, and we're just going to run. Go stand in between.
This little fella, who I definitely didn't forget about last turn, is going to go. And with my last one, I'll buy an extra dice, and we'll see if we can just knock this guy into the dirt. We hit him once.
Okay. He's a zombie, which means he is zombie defense of 7. We're good. All right, then. Well, let's go with Team Skeleton. And he's going to walk over to here and just pop a shot into that guy. He's not obscured, so I get 2 dice. Take 2.
Minus 1 to hit.
I think it's still take 2. On 6s, sorry. Now he hits on 6s, yeah. So just 1.
4 plus. Fails it.
Make your nerve check.
I spent my last one. He's out.
All right, for your roll.
There we go.
6 is good. So he's just knocked down and fatigued. Well, then we're going to charge him with the bats.
Mm-hmm. Pucka, pucka, pucka.
6 plus, 3 attacks.
Get out of here.
Actually, sorry. I'm plus 1 because you're knocked down.
To hit?
Yeah.
Okay. So a nerve check.
That's armor.
Check armor. Yeah, he's still fine. Good, though.
Yep.
I have no one left.
Okay. We'll do the zombie. He's going to stab. Get the zombie. Gets him with an 8.
Reroll it.
Gets him with a 6. No, sorry, it's 7. Wait. It's 6, I got him. Oh, minus 1. So no, I didn't. You get fatigued, yeah.
I'll counter you.
Okay, do it.
Yeah. 1-2.
1-2. Armor is zombie, which means 7s.
Nope. Down he goes.
Yeah, knocked down. All right, well, last but not least, we have this fool. I don't have line of sight to charge, so I'm just going to stand there. We'll just brace, I guess. We'll just walk. Or run, actually, over to here.
Get ready and to pick up.
Get ready to pick that up. Yeah. Yep. 4. You are going first because you finished first. Star dice.
Fun box. Big numbers.
I'm into it.
One more reroll.
5. 6-7.
That's not bad. Still pretty good.
Yeah. We just like more than 4. More than 4 would be sweet. That's good. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. What would you like to do?
Boss is going to go.
Okay.
He's going to charge your man.
My necroman?
Yep.
Okay.
Good luck, everybody. I'm going to go kill this guy.
I got 3 wounds.
How tough are you? Pretty tough?
No.
Necromancer, man. I'm going to buy an extra dice just to make sure.
5 plus armor.
I'm going to go to 6, okay. And I'm going to have another dice.
Okay.
Hitting on 4s.
Yeah. I'm into it.
Needed that extra dice. Take 2. That 3.
3, okay.
Crushing 2.
Armor is 5 plus 6 plus 7 plus.
Down to the ground.
Make my nerve check. I'm going to buy an extra die. Go to 6. And try out the die. We're good. We did okay. We're knocked down and tired.
Yeah. I'm going to spend 1 to chain activate.
Okay.
To 5. But I'm actually going to do a group activation as it to go to 3.
Okay. Your bro's going to charge?
Yeah.
Okay.
So he's going to charge the downed and wounded fella here.
Okay.
And he's going to charge this Batman in the back. Actually, I can't do that then, even though I started in your back arc? How does it work?
Yeah, you get placed.
I end up.
You just go corner to corner. No, you go corner to corner.
Corner to corner.
Yeah, okay. you'd be like that basically.
Okay.
Dabs.
Charging downed guy. I get an extra dice for charging, but plus 1 to hit because you're down.
You got it.
3s. 1, 2, 3, 4.
4.
At crushing 1.
Crushing 1. Okay. I need 6s. Good. Okay. Charge the bats.
So charging, and then does he get plus 1 to hit because he's in your rear? Is that how it worked? Or?
No, you get crushing plus 1.
That's what it is. Okay. So 4s to hit. He gets 1, 2. 2.
2. Bat swarms. Armor 7. I eat 8s. Those are all successes. Nope. One wound. They become knocked down. For me now. Okay. Well, let's pick up and run, I believe is the term.
Short skill pick up, short skill walk.
You got it. Peace out. I'm going to spend one chain activate, okay. And we're going to activate this fella, mm-hmm. And he's going to club you in the back. I'm going to buy a die. Down to 5. Not have your miasma up yet, which is sweet. So I'm gonna hit you on fives.
Yeah.
1, 2.
We roll one of those sixes.
Okay. 1, 2. Crushing two.
Takes two wounds.
So minus one nerve.
Nerve one. Fails. Am I still within six of the big
man? Oh, yeah, I think so, yeah.
Yeah.
You're what?
We'll spend one of our last three to give him two dice. Good.
Down fatigued. I'm then going to spend two power points to place a zombie. And three.
Activated.
He's marked as activated. And then I think I'm just going to walk away. Over to there. And still stay within range of everyone. I'm still be within six of all my friends. The guy fighting the zombie?
Nope, or the guy that just got beat up. And he's just going to stand up. And that'll be his activation.
And then this fatigue goes away. The archer. And he's going to plug that guy with arrows. Okay. With three, because I'll buy one in the open. So it goes to four left. Hitting on five or sixes. One.
Fails.
Nope. Nerve.
Nerve check. Good.
Down he goes. Sit.
All right, well, this fatigue guy, he'll use his one activation to try and step on this zombie's neck. So he's got two dice, but he hits on threes because you're knocked down.
You got it.
Yeah. Take two on eights.
On eights. Ha! Nope. And he's a grunt, so he's just dead because he's knocked out already. Fatigued, you can't consolidate because you retaliated. Oh, yep. Oh, sorry, you can consolidate, yeah, so you just don't get a second action.
There we go.
Go with the bats. We're going to stand up.
And be alive.
And the T guy's gonna stand up.
Stand up as well, just like your bats did. And we can just stare at each other.
Everyone's gonna keep fighting.
Yep. There we go.
And charge. Blam.
Yep.
Two attacks on the charge. One.
Five up.
You got it.
Oh, no nerve check. He'll buy a dice.
Okay.
Yeah. Attaboy.
He won't. Not gonna retaliate.
Nope. He'll kill you on his active turn.
Okay.
She's gonna do her aura again.
Yep, makes sense.
And then we're gonna heal this fella here. So, come on, give me a point. Back to full.
Okay. He's just gonna stand up.
Yep.
As you do.
Guy who got hit, he'll hit back.
Do it.
Turn to face. Give you a little bit of the stabs. They're 2 dice base, right? No, I left.
One.
I think that's just one.
I got a six, yeah. Two hits. Five up for me. Laughs. Retaliate, because why not? Be unfatigued. Miss. Attacks me. We'll stab over here. One attack. Hits.
Who else is fatigued over here? That guy. He's probably dead anyway. So let's just try and live. Yeah. He's okay.
Eight.
Yep. Two dice. 2d8. Looking for fives. Take a hit.
Five up. Good.
You're good.
We're just going to stand at the boss.
That's that.
And then, nope, I got this work. He's just gonna walk around behind you.
I thought he stood up this time.
No, he was stood up last turn. I didn't do anything else. Sit right there. That's round. That's the last turn of the game, turn five. You got your power dice first. You ended last turn first, so you were going first. Mm-hmm. Sorry, I'm gonna buy off two fatigues at the end of the round. I'm gonna buy off. Who is fatigued?
That guy.
Yeah, I guess we'll buy that one off. Five.
Two, four, five.
Six. Six for me. Two. Log on wrong. Over to you. Gonna go.
Four dice. He'll buy a dice down to five. And just try and kill your boss.
Do it.
Fours.
Duel me.
Oh, that's good. Five.
Sure.
Six. At crushing two.
So I need sevens. Six on sevens. You can do it. Oops. Make five. One, take five. And so I'm minus four to my roll, so I need eight.
Because you're
I might as well spend one. Give me that eight. Nope, it goes. Oops. It's all eight, and you still have a short skill.
I'm going to use my inspiring, because I just obliterated a guy, to remove fatigue off of my knight. Actually, it doesn't matter, because he's basically dead. So I'm just going to do my overrun. I killed that guy. And then I'll use my short skill to head towards this fella.
Cool. And he's done?
Yep. Boom. We're going to go with Lady Wizard here.
Yep.
She's going to pop her aura.
Okay.
And then second skill, she's going to stand aside and let these guys deal with this.
It's fair. Let's do Kill Orc. He's going to charge this guy in the rear.
Yep.
Boop. 3, plus 1 hit, because, oh, shit, not knocked down. It's crushing, plus 1. Hitting on 5s go to 6s.
Reroll the 6.
Okay. 7. Okay. Hit you once at crushing 2.
6 plus save. Nope, takes a wound.
I take a wound. I'm crushing 1. They don't have crushing base. They're just vicious. Mob assault. Stand up.
Shrug it off. Be alive.
Well, I think we're going to try and charge this guy. Because I charge 10. Pathfinder. Charge him in the rear. I think I fail. I can go right through the woods, though, because I have Pathfinder.
Yep.
8 and 2. Oh, I fail.
Just behind.
Pre-measure. So, now you have to move that guy.
Okay, Mark.
Let's go charge, I guess, somebody else. I should run down there anyway. I think the best thing to do, actually, is spend my last one for a group assault. All three of these guys are going to charge.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to go on the flank. We're going to go on the flank. And we're going to go on the front. Not that it matters because it's still your front. Do him first. So I've got 2d8, plus 1 for charging, plus 1 for a friend. So 4, hitting on 5s go to 6s because of your aura.
Nothing.
Almost got 3, hitting on 6s go to 7s. Nope. And then Skelly Man gets 2, goes to 3, sorry, because there's a friend there. I think the 6 is a hit. It's on a 7, never mind. 3 Skelly Mans are different. He's gonna go.
Stab that guy.
Get him.
We'll just swing. Hitting on 5s.
1. 1. 5 up. Nope. Okay. Down he goes. Doesn't walk about, yep. We'll go with the bat. The bat will attack the wounded guy. It was bat wings. 7 will hit.
Reroll it. Parry.
7 will hit.
All right. Armor 4. Nope.
Take a wound.
Nerve bad. Nope, good enough.
He goes, dumb it on out. He'll stand. Okay.
And be done.
Mr. Dr. the Orc will go. And he'll spin.
Fight
you.
Knight.
2 attacks.
8 will hit. Only 8.
Okay. Nope.
6.
Vicious. 6 will hit. 2, twice.
He's 8 on 5 normally, right?
Yeah.
Armor 4. Fails 1. So he's down as well. Nerve. Dead. Brave Sir Robin.
So he's just downed, yeah. Stand back up for his activation, yeah.
Yep, and that'll be him.
My last little fell, or second last little fell over here is gonna go, and he'll hit you. 1d8. Hits.
Hit on 5s, eh? You guys are as good as mine.
Pretty sure. No, I sorry, it's a 6. I missed. Okay. It's a 6.
Gotcha. So it'll fatigue me and activate me, and I will not hit you.
Little cuckoo. This guy's gonna go. He's gonna run 8. Oh, sorry, that was you. Or me, rather, so it's you again.
Yeah, so this guy's gonna go, and he'll hit the orc behind him.
Let's make a stab.
We'll buy a dice. Go to 3. And hitting on 4s.
2. 2. 5 up.
2.
There. Down he goes. Just knocked down a stunt, because his command model nearby. Okay. This is this guy. He's gonna run.
Walk 4.
Yeah, well, it's a run. You can only take each action once. I run twice.
I thought your movement's locked.
Pick up and run. Go behind you, somebody your arc.
Going 8.
Back to here. We're done, doesn't yeah.
End.
See if the game keeps going. Roll for it, pop up.
Yeah!
The tablet is mine. Probably gonna charge me next turn.
He charges 14.
He charges, well, so you have the ability, that's right.
Yeah.
Got a fight left.
2 hits against your bat.
Okay. Bat is armor 7, it was 8. Nope.
Got it.
Not an activation. All right, so at the end of it all, I lost the boss and the gore blights, and everybody else is a grunt. We get to roll for your old battle wounds, and he's a pretty big deal. So let's see what we got for casualties. So for the boss, Rashraz the Tall, what happens? Red will be high. He, 53, is slow recovery. Model survives, take a long time to recover. Miss your next game. Big monster man, the huddle. What happens to the huddle? 21, that's going to be haunting nightmares. The wound stays, I mean, he is screaming all the time. His nerve is up by 1. You lost was grunts, so no big deal there.
We lost green.
Green went down. Green went down. And we're going into retinue assessment. All right, so retinue assessment. Promotions. We've got retinue slots available for everybody. A leader can promote 1 of their existing troops into the vacant role at a cost of 3 CGs, following the normal restrictions for warband composition rule. So I'm going to promote the huddle and make it the big guy. The mauler, and he gets bonus thump. If the model with the mauler roll causes a wound but doesn't kill it, it may immediately make a second attack against the same target with a single die before any retaliations. And then unique roll XP. He gains 1 additional XP if it survives a game, even if it removes a casualty, and it causes 6 or more unsaved wounds. And then advancement options, at rank 4, the model gets plus 1 to its melee dice. Rashraz and the huddle both were knocked out, so they gain no experience points. I also can't hand out an MVP because the male leader was down. But my Crypt Gouger, Gunter, and my 2 zombie orcs can both gain an XP for surviving the game. So you're going to buy and promote your wizard to be an arcanist for 3 campaign gold, which will take you down to...
3?
Okay. And I'll gain 16 campaign gold for the win. You'll get 10 for the loss. And then we got a forage. I think as well that your 3 knights that leveled up all gained a wound, and so did your boss. Yeah. Because you decided to go for the not random result. You get an extra D8 campaign gold. Ha! Which is 2. And then foraging for the second D8 roll, and it's going to be on this other chart. 21. Frostbite. Despite searching for hours across a sizable area, you find nothing. Even worse, someone in your party begins to suffer from frostbite. One random command, large, or spellcaster model in your roster will get frostbite. This takes effect during the next game, and they begin with 1 less wound. Due to the fact that I've basically already got frostbite, being rotten, but it's going to be Rashraz. So I have 1, 2, 3, 4...
I mean, I guess it would be the guy who randomly shows up next time, right?
5 large guys. Sorry, 5 people. So I need a D10. 6. 3. So it's going to be Gilbert, the vampire halfling. 32 potential campaign gold and 29 unspent. And I gain back food equal to D8. So 4 extra food. Plus minuses, I'm at 21 food left for all the foraging. And it's over to you. So roll for your campaign gold. You get D8.
Back here. Yeah.
6. And then your extra exploration die.
2.
That's going to be treasure hoard. You find an old chest. You gain 1 unique equipment item and 3 campaign gold. Roll D8 for your cool unique item. 2. Holy hand grenades. It's a range attack, range 6, piercing 2, area of effect 2 inches, 2d8 piercing 1. That's an 8-point holy hand grenade. It's not consumable. You have as many as you want. You can have a range attack.
Yes, Margaret is wielding the grenade.
Margaret has a holy hand grenade. Food roll. You were minus 10 because you had 10 folks leave. Yep.
So I lost 6 food.
6 food
over. 34.
All said and done, doing a little bit of shopping. I think you're buying some heavy weapons.
Probably
some heavy weapons for some dudes. And then I'm going to buy, I think probably the flame scroll for the man, the legend, that is Gunter, the Crypt Flayer, Crypt Gouger. And then we both have to do some painting because I need to paint my halfling vampire and my support pieces because my necromancer is not showing up for the next game. We need some more command models. All right, so we go into the game, taking the tablet home, reading the evil writings so we can raise more zombies and wake up the halfling from his eternal rest.
Yep.
He's got some frostbite, though. Apparently we left him out there too long, and now he's a little bit brittle. Pieces of him are falling off and stuff. So we'll see for that one in 2 weeks. Both of us have to paint, so like, I got to paint my wraith. I got to paint my revenants.
Just archers.
Just archers.
The next batch is just more all the archers of the company are going to
come out. A wave of guns. Yeah. Fair enough. We'll see for that soon until I sound Ash the Zone. Operating. I hope you enjoyed that video. If you want to support the channel, of course, like and subscribe and hit the little bell below so you get notifications when I post future content. I do post stuff 7 days a week. If you want to support the channel further, you can, of course, buy a t-shirt through Spreadshirts, buy a measuring gauge or objective markers from Death Grip Designs. Or, of course, most importantly, there is Patreon. Patreon is what makes all this possible. Keeps the lights on, pays for the studio costs, pays for the equipment, model costs, and everything else. And most importantly, puts food in my kids' bellies and a roof over their heads. Big thanks to everyone past, future, who supported me. I do this stuff because of you guys, and of course, I will continue doing it as long as I can.